Welcome, everybody. It is Tuesday, July 17th, and because the market is seeing a lot of action, I want to talk about what's going on. So before I get too far into it, I want to let you know that I'm not a financial advisor, and this is not financial advice. So let's get right into it. In the news, we're going to talk about, is this really a bull run, and why is the market up? And then also a little bit about one of my favorite projects, which is Open Platform, which is going to be Open Chain very soon. And I want to talk about some of the details and information I have on that. So is the market really bullish? Well, a lot of the coins are up, which when Bitcoin is up, that tends to happen. But if you go and you look at the charts for just about any coin, I'd say 99% of them, they are all showing some sort of bullish trend. That doesn't mean that one over another is going to just go to the moon, but the market is showing good trends. We do have a couple lines that we want to pass, that $6,800 mark for Bitcoin and then also the $7,200 mark. And if we pass both of those before the weekend, I think we could see a very, very strong beginning of next week. Also, there's some crypto news that is actually causing some of this uptrend in the market. Let's get into that. So first off, Coinbase has been okayed by the US government to list securities. This is very, very good because it means they can list just about any coin they want, and other exchanges will be able to as well and apply for that. I think this is extremely positive because it leads a little bit more towards regulation. And we all know that there's some problems with ICOs and a lot of fake ones out there. I think one of the latest numbers I've seen is 60% of ICOs are dead in 4 months. So we do need some regulation, but I think this is going to be better than expected to where they're not going to try to control the industry as a whole. Up next, we're talking about the U.S. Congress and their meetings on Wednesday. One of these meetings is to discuss ETFs or electronically traded funds. As you can imagine, no investment companies really want to hold on to the actual commodity or security itself. So, and consider it like gold. How many investment companies really actually hold on to the physical gold, but yet they invest in it? The same thing when it comes to crypto. And we struggle enough to hold on to our private keys and use all that information. It can be very difficult for an individual to get into crypto. Well, they're trying to make it easier. And that's what this will help do. That's kind of the short, basic description of what's going to happen or what they're going to try to pass. The next news is about IBM launching a coin that is going to be backed and insured by the FDIC. This is huge news, because it now makes the opportunity for mass adoption that much easier and quicker. And then also the information about BlackRock strongly considering crypto. Well, if you don't know much about BlackRock, they control about $4.2 trillion in investments. And yes, I did say 4.2 trillion. They are considered the largest investment management company in the world. And if they're getting into crypto, you can see a lot more companies coming in soon. And then the last thing that I want to talk about regarding the market indicators, I saw a couple weeks ago, which was Facebook announcing that they were going to allow crypto and blockchain companies to run ads again. And I think it was early this year, they decided to ban all crypto ads. And that really impacted the trending conversations and topics that would happen around crypto, Bitcoin, Ethereum, or any other coin. By them allowing these ads now, I think is kind of the start to this. When I saw that 2 weeks ago, Bitcoin was at $5,800. And at that point I called out, this is probably the low. I do expect that that was the low, and we will see YouTube and Google follow suit soon. So the last thing I want to discuss is about one of my favorite projects, which is Open Platform. For most of the that don't know, Open Platform will soon be coming Open Chain. They're going to launch their own blockchain. There's a lot of information coming out, but I want to talk about the distributions, the snapshots, what our expectations are, and then also about some announcements coming. So regarding the token swap, in the next 2 weeks, we will see our third private sell distribution. We will see our second bounty distribution, and then we're also going to see the second public snapshot. I have a feeling we've seen a private snapshot, but I can't confirm that. Also, there will be a new form coming. For those that didn't get in for the 2 times, you can get in for the 1.75 times bonus, and that will probably be next week, I'm guessing. Just to give you a little bit of information on the 2-time bonus, I am part of a group that did invest quite a bit into the private sale, And I know there were a lot of people that bought their coins, went on with their business, didn't pay attention to what's going on. So they actually missed out on the two times. So if you are lucky enough to have invested in getting in on the two-time bonus, that will be a huge benefit for you, because I don't think there's going to be as much bonus as I initially expected. I initially thought there would be about 1.7 billion coins in distribution total or in circulation. That includes team coins, partner coins, and all circulation. But I think that's likely to be somewhere around 1.5 million, and I wouldn't be surprised, or 1.5 billion, and I wouldn't be surprised if that's even closer to 1.4 billion. So the token swap is still scheduled for late August. There could be some changes with that, but you know, they're working as hard as they can, and I'll get into more of that here in a minute. So all of us have high expectations when it comes to our investments. Well, ICOs probably have more high expectations than anybody else. And if you're not getting some huge, huge news out of an ICO, then people just kind of throw it off to the side. But I want to let you know that this team is working very hard. There are partnerships coming. They just can't be announced yet. And then let's talk about the pricing and exchanges. Yeah, the price is a little lower than what most of us would like to be, but the market has been lower. So that's part of a deal. Also, you have some people who are pushing the price down to try to accumulate more open and to get in on these next two bonuses. So don't get frustrated over the price. It is going to come up, and I expect it to really increase if we get into that bull run. Next thing, you're going to see the test net in the next couple weeks. So that's super huge news, which could be a price bump. And if you go and you take a look at their GitHub compared to most other coins, they are very, very active, and probably more active than just about anybody else out there. So I want to tell you, don't worry about the news too much. It is going to come, and it's going to be big news. But I have spoken with the team, and I'm going to read you off a little bit of what was told to me. So right now we're trying to balance those forces out while pushing engineering at full force. So once the macro climate is more encouraging, we will be the best project to take advantage of the opportunity. That's extremely bullish news, and I hope that you have invested in Open and be a part of the community. Join their Telegram. I'll have links to their site below, and I want to let you know I'm extremely pleased to announce that they have made some changes to their website. If you haven't been there recently, they have added their team page back and updated a few other things. So I highly suggest you go take a look. So I want to thank you all for watching. Please like, click the alert button below so you know when I create new content. Share with your friends, and I hope you all have a great day.